Lumos Maxima.
What Joe has done is create this world where wizards and muggles are living side by side, but the muggles are not aware of it. And so the headquarters of MACUSA is the Woolworth building.
It's different to the Ministry of Magic in London in the sense that the same building is occupied in different dimensions. So it's a muggle building till you know the right way to get in, and then whoomph, it changes, and then you're inside MACUSA.
The Woolworth building at the time was the tallest building in the world. We have tried to represent the entire footprint of the building, but we haven't anywhere near. The real thing is much bigger than our very big set. Inside the real building, it's not open plan, it's a series of small offices. And so I had to think of something to do with it that would actually elevate it to something, well, ultimately magical, really. The chief decision with that in mind was to eliminate the floors. So the lobby level is just open space. All the windows are exposed, and it's this vast, tall cathedral of light. There are basement floors where all the work is done. And the further down you go, the more menial the work, and the more dreadful the conditions.
Hey, Gina. Where's Queenie? Abernathy let her go home. She said she felt sick.
Again.
Little cut there.
We imagined the pentagram was hundreds and hundreds of years old. It's all carved wood, all the decoration is carved wood. It was very loosely, I suppose, modelled on the Houses of Parliament.
I was astonished. Every extra could have been the leading man or lady. They were exquisite, and everyone looked different. There was nothing repeated.
Wizards from Hungary and from Mongolia and Russia, from Thailand, and wizards from Ireland and wizards from Pakistan, and it was amazing.
And folks, just take the weight off your feet for a minute or two. We'll be rehearsing in a sec.
Thanks, everyone. Very quiet.
Tina, she burst in, became the victim in the centre of the floor with this tiered seats and the delegates from around the world sort of glaring down at her. It was a good, intimidating space, and that's exactly what it was supposed to be.
Impound that case, Bruce.
Keep that back.
Arrest them.
No, not the case. Please don't understand. Nothing in there is dangerous. Nothing.
An action.
Do you want me to take a message to your family?
The death cell is almost like being put to death in their Swiss clinic. Everybody's eerily nice, but they're putting you to death. It's going to be kind of almost a shock to the audience, I think, because it's such a cold and weird scene. It's almost like being in a David Lynch film.
The death chamber was an interesting, different look down in the bowels of this place, below the basement levels in the foundation. It's very clinical. The walls are lined with white marble, like a mortuary. Right above it are massive cast iron beams, which are the very foundation of the building. So you get the sense you are deep, deep, deep underground, which helps the secret, sinister connotations of the place.
Thank you for all of the support you've given our film. It's a privilege to be a part of this new era of magic.
We all hope that you have a brilliant time celebrating and reliving the magic of Harry Potter and Fantastic Beasts.
Sort of makes me want to be a wizard.